Welcome students, we are studying advanced materials and this is your lecture number 3. We already completed 2 lectures and after completing this lecture, you will be able to know the various materials which are used in bearings and their properties. You will be able to explain the smart materials, their properties and their application in the industries. In the previous 2 lectures, in the lecture 1, we completed composite material, ceramic materials and heat insulating materials. In the lecture 2, we discussed about the adhesive materials and materials for nuclear energy. In this lecture, we will have discussion about materials for bearing metals and smart materials. First, we will see the materials which are used in bearing metals. So, a bearing is a machine element which is used to support the rotating components like shaft, spindle, so that it can transmit power or motion from one place to another place. A good bearing material should have the following properties to improve the efficiency of machine or rotating element. It should have low coefficient of friction to reduce the power loss. It should have high resistance to wear so that it does not get wear out and improve the performance of a machine. It should have high strength and toughness. It should have high melting point, because when rotating elements are transmitting power, there is an increase in temperature at the bearing surface, and if the bearing material have high melting point, then it does not get distorted due to the increase in temperature, or it does not get distorted due to the decrease in temperature. It should have high melting point. It should have high thermal conductivity so that the heat generated at the bearing surface should be removed easily. It should have high corrosion resistance, because sometimes bearings are also used in the corrosive environment. So it should have high corrosion resistance. It should be economical as per the requirement of their application. So these are the properties a bearing material should possess to improve the quality and performance of a machine or element. The common materials which are used in bearing application are of mainly 3 types. The first one is your white metal, which is also known as Babbitt metals, and it is a lead based or tin based alloy in which tin is present from 82 to 93%, copper 2.5 to 3.5%, and antimony 3.5 to 10.5%. The Babbitt metals have properties of less friction, high strength, good cast ability and high corrosion resistance. Because of these properties, it is used in high speed and heavy duty applications like engines, bearings and turbines. The second type of bearing material which are used is copper based alloy. So in this material, it is a tin bronze, lead bronze and aluminium bronze alloy. In a tin bronze alloy, 5 to 20% of tin. In a lead bronze alloy, copper is 80%, tin 10% and lead is 10%. In aluminium bronze alloy, aluminium present 8 to 11% and iron present 3 to 7%. So the properties, it is harder and stronger than white materials. It is having a anti-friction properties and good machinability. Because of its hardness and it is stronger than the white metals, it is used in high load and heavy pressure applications. The third type of bearing materials which are commonly used is non-metal bearing materials. This type of bearing materials is also known as nylon and teflon. And in this material, the nylon and teflon is reinforced with glass or graphite material to increase its resistance, wear resistance. The properties, it is having a heat resistance, high toughness and abrasion resistance, low friction and chemical resistant properties. Because of these properties, it is used in light load and low speed and corrosive conditions. Because it is chemical resistant material and it is having a heat resistant property, it is used in corrosive conditions. These are the bearing materials which are commonly used in the bearing applications. Next is your smart materials. So the knowledge of material science will help you to improve the properties and classification of materials by combining two or more materials together so that a best material can be obtained for the desired application. The smart materials are the advancement in material science which is used in the advanced technologies such as space, electronics or solar power, satellites, etc. So smart materials are those materials that have response to environment change. When there is an environment change like temperature, pressure, electrical or mechanical, because of these changes, the smart material activate or deactivate itself or perform their functions according to the changes in the environment. The smart materials having a properties of sensing and acuting. It should sense the movement, rotation or the movement, rotations and activate itself according to the movement and rotation, and it should have acuting properties to control the motion of elements by self, and it should have a self-control and self-repairing properties. It should have shock absorber and damage arrest properties, and it should have a properly feedback system so that it can improve itself or it can improve its function while the environment changes occur. So there are many types of smart materials in the outside environment, but we are studying only common elements or common smart materials which is used in the industries or practical applications. So first type of smart material is your piezoelectric materials. This type of material activate or deactivate itself with the mechanical behavior of materials. So in this type of material, it converts the mechanical stress into an electric voltage or electric voltage into a mechanical stress. Its example is, you can see that the dance floor which is made of smart material or piezoelectric material, when there is a movement on the dance floor, the light will on, and when there is no movement, the light will go off. So this is the example of piezoelectric material and the application of piezoelectric material. We can make by the piezoelectric material, we can generate energy. As you can see that if we apply the piezoelectric materials on the tire of automobile, we can generate energy from there, and we can generate energy by making a charging pad. Whenever there is a movement, whenever there is a human being walking on the piezoelectric material, there will be a stress on the material, and this stress will be converted into an electric voltage by the piezoelectric material, and this electric energy will be stored in a battery. So by this application, you can harvest the energies from every applications in the industries. So piezoelectric materials has a wide applications, and it is widely used in nowadays. So next type of material is a photovoltaic material. These materials has similar properties like piezoelectric materials, but these materials convert the light into electric energy. For example, a solar panel. In a solar panel, the sun rays or the light coming from the sun is converted into an electric energy by a photovoltaic material which is used in a solar panel. So it is used in a spacecraft and satellite also. Third type of smart material is a magnetostrictive materials. Magnetostrictic materials changes its shape whenever there is a magnetic field, or you can say that whenever there is a change in a magnetic field, the magnetostrictive material changes its shape, or if there is a change in the shape of the magnetostrictive material, there will be a change in the magnetic field. So this type of smart material is used in the energy harvesting or generating the electricity. As you all know the Faraday laws, when there is a change in a magnetic field around a coil, there will be a voltage generation, and this law and magnetostrictive materials are used in the energy harvesting applications. For example, as you seen here, If we apply a force, this is the magnetostructive material. If we apply a compressive force, there is a change in shape of magnetic magnetostructive material. And when there is a strain developed in this material, there is a change in the magnetic flux around this coil. And because there is change in magnetic flux, there will be a electric current or electric voltage, which is further stored in a battery, and electrical energy can be created. For this is the example of cantilever beam, and this cantilever beam example is used here in a bridge condition. In a bridge condition, there is always changing in a loading condition. Load always change, frequently change, and because of change in a load, there will be change in a stress and strain on the material. If we use the magnetostructive material here on the bridge and apply a coil, this coil. Apply this coil on this magnetostructive material, and there will be a change in the magnetic flux, and we will generate energy, electrical energy. So this is the example of magnetostructive material. So magnetostructive material having an application in the transducer, sonar system, vibration control, and energy harvesting systems. Next type of smart material is your rheological materials. Rheological materials are a fluid type materials which changes its shape from state from liquid to solid or solid to liquid under the influence of magnetic or electric field. The material which change its state under the influence of magnetic field is known as magnetorheological fluid, and the material which change its state from liquid to solid or solid to liquid is known as electrorheological material or electrorheological fluid. Here is the typical example or illustration of magnetorheological fluid. These are the two electromagnetic, in which electromagnetic there is a normal fluid and a magnetic rheological magnetic fluid. This is the condition when there is no magnetic field, and when magnetic field is on, this will be the condition. These magnetic particle will arrange in a line and act as a solid medium, and this will be used in a shock absorber condition or in a armor condition. So rheological materials are widely used in automobile suspension and shock absorber, in military body armor, in optical industries, in clutches and brakes, and in aerospace industries and medical instruments. Next type of material is a shape memory alloy smart materials. So this type of shape memory alloy smart materials this name implies that it stores the memory of its shape inside itself. So the example is this: when there is a change in temperature, these materials are the temperature responsive material. When there is a change in temperature, they can get deformed, or they can regain their original shape. For example, this is the original wire. Okay, when it gets twisted due to the load application or some other environmental condition, so this twisted wire will regain its shape when it's heated above 90 degree temperature. So this type of shape memory alloy is widely used in robotic application, as you are seeing here in the robotic hand applications. And this type of alloy is used in aerospace industries, in a fighter jet application, when the speed of the fighter jet is above the sonic speed, then there is a change, there is high temperature develop, and at that condition the shape memory alloy regain its original shape at a high temperature condition. It is used in robotics, used in eyeglass frames, used in medical industries, in endodontics, orthodontics, is used in dampers applications. So these are the five common smart materials which are widely used. Some other materials, smart materials, are pH sensitive materials which change their shape according to the change in the level of pH. Self-repairing materials are those materials which can repair itself by their mechanism. Ferrofluid materials are the materials which is made by the ferromagnetic materials, or it act as a fluid, photomechanical smart materials and thermoelectric smart materials. There are many, many more smart materials which are used in the practical application, but these are the common smart materials which are used, widely used in our day-to-day life. So that's all for today. So this will complete your topics of advanced materials. I hope you all understand the topics which we are discussed in these three lectures. Let me know if there is any other improvement in these lectures by giving comments and suggestion in the comment box. So thank you.